Alright, let me get this part out of the way right now. This is a pretty nice synth thing going on here. Yeah, it's pretty alright. Reminds me a little of Call Me by Blondie, and anything that reminds me of Call Me by Blondie is doing at least one thing right. Okay, got that out of the way. Now, onto the important part. Who the hell is this guy, and why do I know he exists? My instant reaction to this song has been the same each and every time. This man does not deserve to be famous. This song may as well be called I Have No Star Qualities by Nobody McLoser. The name of the song is Cooler Than Me. The name of the guy is Mike Posner. Mike Posner, for crying out loud. By contrast, take a look at this guy. This guy's name is Tayo Cruz. He didn't even have a choice but to become a pop singer. Tayo Cruz is the name of a pop star. Mike Posner fixes your car. And you know that they're aware of this on some level because they're just trying so hard to convince me that Mike Posner is the hot new superstar of the future. Check out the video where he's rocking out in his awesome concert before heading off to the awesome after party. Posner! Posner! Yeah, I'm sure.
Porchy is one outrageous dude! He's totally in my face!
It's not just his name or the unfortunate title of his song, it's everything about the guy, especially his singing voice. But you don't know the way that you look. And listen to him, he's not so much singing as he is failing to rap. The closest way I can describe his vocal style is that he sounds like that guy singing along to his headphones who doesn't realize that people around him can hear him.
You got your highbrow shoes on your feet and you wear them around.
Breath control, damn it! Sing from the diaphragm! His voice is so weak that I just assumed that he was one of those guys like Kevin Rudolph or David Guetta, studio production people who got sick of making hits for other people and incorrectly decided that they had enough charisma to get in front of the camera, but I looked it up and apparently that's not the case at all. AllMusic says that he's a recent college grad who made hip-hop mixtapes in school, and that his only notable work is his debut album named 31 Minutes to Take Off, which is in itself a pretty optimistic guess for the length of his career. In fact, AllMusic compares him to Asher Roth, the idol of college guy. Which is already a harsher put down than anything I'm gonna be able to come up with. I mean, damn AllMusic, what did Mike Posner do to you? So, to sum up, he has no charisma, no presence, no particular talent for performance, and no notable behind-the-scenes accomplishments. Also, he looks a bit like Screech trying to pass himself off as Justin Timberlake. Now, given that unimpressive rundown of this guy's meager talents, I think there's only one possible conclusion. He must be an excellent songwriter. So let's take a look at his lyrical stylings.
If I could write you a song to make you fall in love, I would already have you up under my arm. I used up all of my tricks. I hope that you like this, but you probably won't. You think you're cooler than me.
Ah, yes. The old lovelorn song from the poor guy who just can't melt the ice-cold heart of the popular girl. Yeah, I'm certainly familiar with this kind of song, although of course, I have no personal experience with it. But that kind of song can be dangerous. When you write a song like that, you run the risk of looking sympathetic or likable. Well, fear not. Mike Posner has the solution. So he spends the rest of the song detailing the way she's a total snob and how mean she is. Seriously, dude, get over it. You struck out. Move on.
I hope that you like this, but you probably won't. You think you're cooler than me. And you never say hey or remember my name, and it's probably cause you think you're cooler than me.
Okay, this is just me, but I think it may have been a mistake to write a chorus where every line ends with you think you're cooler than me. Cause it seems to me that he set himself up for a very obvious rebuttal.
And you never say hey or remember my name, and it's probably cause you think you're cooler than me.
Yes, I think I'm cooler than you! I think 12-year-olds who write gay Sonic the Hedgehog porn fiction are cooler than you! And I keep waiting for him to get to the part where he explains why I'm not cooler than him, and he just never gets there! Whenever I hear the chorus of the song, this is how it comes across to me. Yeah, you think you're cooler than me? You think you're so much cooler than me? Yeah, yeah? Well, let me tell you something. You are... washing machine! Yeah, you heard me! I said it! Actually, though, maybe he does get in a decent put-down in the verses. Let's see.
You got designer shades just to hide your face, and you wear them around like you're cool.
Oh! Burn! Yeah, I bet you think you look so cool in your stupid, trendy, overpriced sunglasses. Yeah, yeah, you don't even realize that all those things do is make you look like a complete... wait. Oh, you're kidding me! Yeah, you know, the way these songs usually go is something like, you and your whole scene are a bunch of trendy asswipes. Not, I'm a bigger, trendier asswipe than you'll ever be! Now, come on, you gotta really tear into her in the other verses, right? You know, I say things like verses and chorus, but I'm not sure this song is either of those things. I just feel like I'm hearing the same four measures over and over again, something I refer to as Coldplay syndrome. But anyway, let's see what else Posner has in his verbal arsenal.
You got your highbrow shoes on your feet, and you wear them around like it ain't sh- but you don't know the way that you look when your steps make that much noise.
That's what you're going with? That her footsteps are noisy? Okay, one, where are you trying to pick this girl up that you can hear her footsteps? A violin recital? Was she wearing tap shoes? What? Secondly, it's still not much of a put-down. Look, I am way out of your league, and I am so not interested. Oh yeah? Well, you got loud shoes! Seriously, you gotta try a lot harder than that if you wanna- Don't shush me, you snot-nosed little twerp! Oh, and another thing, it is totally not her fault she can't remember your name.
You never say, hey, you'll remember my name.
You want people to remember your name, get a better name, Mark. So you can go by, I don't know, M-Dog, M-80, Mike in the Shadows, Dirk Diggler, anything else, just get a decent stage name, for God's sakes.
You need everyone's eyes just to feel seen behind Jamaica. Nobody knows who you even are, who do you think that you are?
Dude, you suck at this. Songs like this are supposed to be vicious, not these limp little half-ass things. What did any of that even mean? You want to call her a bitch, just call her a bitch, dude. No, not like that.
Cause it sure seems you got no doubt, but we all see you got your head in the clouds.
Yeah, we all see. Yeah, yeah, sure. I love that, because Posner wrote the song, so he's perfectly free to say that the whole crowd doesn't like her. Yeah, yeah, sure. And then they all high-fived him for being so awesome, and then he bagged three hotter girls and they flew to Nicaragua to save the president's daughter. Whatever, dude. I mean, it doesn't even matter what he puts there. He can say whatever he wants because of the way the song's written, he already lost. Dude, you hit on her. You got shot down. You were the one trying to impress her. She is, by definition, cooler than you. Obviously, her designer shades and highbrow shoes are doing something for her, otherwise you wouldn't be whining like a bitch about it.
If I could write you a song to make you fall in love, I would already have you up under my arm.
But you don't. Cause you can't. Cause you suck. You see how that works, right? Yeah, so remember, when you want to make your anti-cool kids anthem, but want to erase every speck of superiority you might have had, well, Mike Posner has the solution. And it's not like I'm against judging people based on very superficial things like their shoes or their sunglasses. I basically do the same thing each and every single day with every person I meet. I am entirely comfortable with the idea. Let me do it right now. This guy's a jerk. This guy's a jerk. This guy's a jerk. Oh, that guy's definitely a jerk. But see, the difference is, I don't spend my day sucking up to people that I am judging as lame, making me also cooler than you. And you want to know the sad part, the really sad part? He's still hitting on her.
I used up all of my tricks. I hope that you like this, but you
probably... Yep, apparently this is his last trick. Just being a colossal dickbag to the girl straight to her face. Smooth, pal. I bet it works too. It's not like this song is terrible, it's more like this song doesn't even really exist. It's one of the biggest hits in the country right now, and I really doubt that even regular pop listeners could identify the song or the singer or any lyrics. It's not particularly catchy, it's just not something that anyone at all really cares about. I'm probably the only person in the universe who cared to look closely enough to realize how pathetically insecure and unintentionally revealing this pissy load of sour grapes really is. And at the end of the day, you just gotta feel sorry for the poor guy. Because after he doesn't have any more hits, this is going to be a particularly embarrassing song to sing at the state fair 10 years from now. It's probably 'cause you think you're cooler. Yeah. I'm gonna be wrong, he's gonna have like dozens more hits. It's always the way it works. No, I don't want no scrub. A scrub is a guy that can't get no love from me. Banging up the passenger side. Oh, by the way, what the hell are highbrow shoes? They like shoes that watch a lot of foreign movies? Okay, I'm done.